Most software these days charges per seat, meaning that every user you add into your account that you're trying to collaborate with is going to increase your monthly or at least annual bill. But I'm happy to say that this is not the case with one of our favorite no-code tools, SmartSuite. In this video, I'm going to be going through the guest user role inside of SmartSuite, detailing how it's going to save you a ton of money, especially if you work with people in a very limited capacity. The guest role will not increase your bill, but you're still going to be able to collaborate and interact with others. If you want to learn more about this very underrated topic, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get the most out of your no-code tools, and SmartSuite is one of our favorite no-code tools in 2024. Now, in this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be breaking down the idea of the guest role and how it's going to help save you money on your SmartSuite bill. But before we get into the heart of it, I first want to invite you to join me for automation training. Automation is one of those key pieces of learning how to work inside of no code. And if you can master the fundamentals of automation, it will really help you get ahead in your job and business. So in this training, I'm giving it away for free. Sign up at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. And it doesn't matter what tool you're using, you can build these automations to save you massive time on the back end. They all follow the same rules. Now, without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. I encourage you to follow along with me. If you already have SmartSuite, open it up alongside this video. And if you don't, please consider signing up using our affiliate link that I will supply wherever you found this video. So let's go ahead and hop on in. Here I am inside of my SmartSuite. This is a demo account, but I'm going to actually share it with somebody in the guest role, and we're gonna walk through what that means. Before we get into this though, I first wanna take you to SmartSuite's pricing. And specifically, I'm looking here, maximum number of guests. Check this out. For every paid user you have, you get a certain number of guest users. So if you're on a team plan, for example, and you have one paid user, then you get one additional guest. So if you had a smaller team, let's say 10, 15 people on your team, and each one of them was inside of SmartSuite, well, with 15 people, you could then have 15 additional guest accounts available. And as you tier up in SmartSuite, as you go up on the different plans, if you're in the professional, you're getting 3 per user, and on enterprise, 5. Now, why does this matter? Because the guest account is absolutely free. Now, of course, it's not as exciting as a traditional paid user. Obviously, it's going to come with some restrictions. There's not the same level of accessibility. However, it is still a very, very powerful type of user role. And the fact that it is entirely free and still allows people to collaborate inside of your very databases and solutions, that is a really powerful feature. Now, when would you actually use a guest account versus a traditional, you know, paid user? Well, it really comes down to what you need someone to do inside of your account. If you work with someone in a very limited capacity, let's say they're a contractor and they have very limited access to certain pieces of information within your organization, they might be a good fit for that guest role. Whereas if they're somebody who's in the day-to-day operations and they need their fingers and hands in like everything, guest role probably won't be the best idea for them. Now let's go ahead and go through an example. I'm gonna flip back into SmartSuite. I'm gonna add a new template here, and I'm just gonna go with a marketing template. Let's go ahead and find a good marketing campaigns right here. We're gonna use this template. It's gonna take just a moment to install right into our space. Now, just like that, you can see that this particular thing has already been built out. It's got campaigns, people and personas, designs and content, brand assets, and channels. I'm only using this as an example so that we can showcase what that guest user experience is gonna look like. So here you can see that these tasks have been assigned to me by default because I'm the person who just installed the template. And the first thing I need to do is give somebody guest access. Now, first we have to bring them into our SmartSuite account. So in order to access this, now this assumes that you are at the right level of permissions inside of SmartSuite. That is, you're an admin, a workspace admin for your SmartSuite account. You can swing on down here to workspace admin and you can look at the different people who have access. Click over to manage members and here you'll see a list of all the different folks who've had access. Now down here, I'm going to scroll down and you'll see that I actually have a guest built into my account already. If I can find this fake account, here we go. It's guest McGesterson and their email is hidden here. I'm blurring it out because this is my private email account that I use only personally. But you can see here that the access level that they've been granted is guest level. So if we take this user, this is not a user that would be incurring a bill for us, a charge for us inside a SmartSuite, but we can still assign them access to the database that we just created. So let's actually flip back now to our previous screen where we were inside of our marketing campaign solution. And up at the top, I'm gonna look for guest McGesterson and add them here. Now, right now, this solution is private only to me, but I'm gonna flip on down to advanced permissions and find guest McGesterson and add them here. Now, because guest McGesterson is a guest, they cannot get more access than what a guest will have. Now, essentially what that means as a guest is I can only see those records to which I have been assigned. Furthermore, I am allowed to edit the status of a record that is assigned to me. So as I go through completing my tasks, I can update the status of those records. And lastly, I can, as a guest, collaborate, chat with people within the organization who have access here as well. Let's take this one step at a time and I will show you. But first, we're gonna open up an incognito window and sign in as our guest. Now that I'm signed in on my guest account, guest McGesterson, you can see right here that the account shows up differently from the other one that I was using because this is the guest account. So inside of here, I can scroll down and find that new solution that was just shared with us, marketing campaigns. Now when I go here, I see nothing. I can't see anything across campaigns, people's impersonas, it's all blanked out. And the reason for this is nothing has been assigned to me yet. So this is actually an amazing component of this feature. I don't have to worry about the privacy of my data because if I don't want somebody to see it, I just don't assign it to them. So here, the guest account can see nothing about this. They in no way, shape, or form see any of the information because nothing is shared with them. But we want to see what it looks like. So let's flip back into our admin account. Here I am back in the regular account and here on the assigned to, if I were to remove the assigned to from myself and apply this to guest McGesterson, well, if I flip back now into the guest account, suddenly, magically, this person now can see the new thing that I just shared. So only after it's shared with them can they actually visualize any data. At that point, they can visualize all of the data within that record that anybody else can see. So all of this information is within the record. This is what's accessible when I expand the record view, and therefore, as a guest, I can see that as well. Now, you'll notice that when I look in here, I do also have the option of adding some comments. So if I need to chat with anybody else on the team, I can collaborate directly in this. So here I can at reference the admin account. Can I get a little help here? And I can send this information through. Now this is going to show up right then and there inside of the admin's account, and we can have a collaboration back and forth right inside of SmartSuite, and I'm still not paying for that user. This is above and beyond what I can do in most other software, because usually at a minimum, if I'm collaborating, if I'm chatting with other team members, I'm probably paying for a seat. But not so for SmartSuite. This is one of those areas where this guest account level really goes up to the next level. Okay, so the other part here is gonna be where things show up in my work. My work, remember, I'm back in that guest account. This is where anything that's been assigned to me across any other solution is gonna show up right here. So as a guest, I have access for this. I can look at this and see The due date. Look, there is no due date for this thing that's in some other database solution somewhere else, but I can actually edit this information. I can update this and say it's ready for review, all of this. I cannot edit the due date, which is a good thing in most cases, but I can set a priority for the different components, the different tasks that are assigned to me. So this will help me manage my pipeline and make sure that I get things done on time. And then of course, I can open up these records, this one existing in a completely different solution, and furthermore, chat with anybody here as well. Now you'll notice that from the guest account, I cannot edit anything in the record. And if I hover over here, you're gonna see it says edits to this field are restricted. The guest permission that I have does not allow me to edit records with the exception of the status field. Now you would expect that I could actually update this status, but I cannot in this case, and here's why. Let's flip back into the admin account to get a better understanding. So if I look at my assigned to field, you'll notice that this does not display in my work. So this thereby proves that I can still, as a guest account, see records that are assigned to me, even if they're not associated with my work. But if I want to be able to update the status of something, it has to be connected to a status field. And so here I have the status field planned, complete, in development, etc. I have to link it from the assigned to component and get those two fields talking. Once I update this, then I can flip back into that account. Let's go ahead and refresh our page. And you'll see now that I am able to update the status because it's now associated with the assigned to field. So from the guest account now, I'm able to actually update this and therefore better communicate with the team. So that's it in a nutshell. This is what the guest account unlocks for us. The best part about this, it doesn't matter what tier you're on for SmartSuite, that guest account is free. The only limitation that you have is how many guest accounts you can add to your SmartSuite account, and that is gonna be based on the tier that you're on and the number of paid users that you have. I know we went pretty quickly in this video, so questions that you have that we did not cover, be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building.